We have two Siberian tigers here at the Buffalo Zoo. They're more commonly known as Siberian tigers, but now they're also known as Amur tigers because they live near the Amur River in Russia. There's actually 8 different types of tigers in the world, 3 of which are extinct. And here at the Buffalo Zoo, we have Siberian tigers and a Bengal tiger. And our Bengal tiger is actually a golden Bengal tiger, and it's very rare. There's about 50 of them in captivity. It's actually a genetic mutation just for a color variation. The Siberian tigers are one of the big cat species. Cats are divided into groups, big cats and small cats. The big cats is tigers, jaguars, and leopards. And big cats are called big cats because they have a flexible hyoid bone in their throat that gives them the ability to roar. And small cats have less flexible bone, so they can only purr. Tigers have stripes on their sides and spots on their ears to help them blend into their environment so they can ambush their prey. The spots on the back of their ears are called eye spots, and a lot of animals have those. It's to confuse their prey species to thinking they're looking one way when they're actually looking another way. Siberian tigers have very powerful legs, and they can leap in excess of 8 to 10 meters. They also hunt at night, mostly by ambush, and are only successful in 1 to 20 of their attempts. Siberian tigers are biologically adapted to live in the cold. They have a little thicker fur than the other tiger species, and it's a little thicker on their paws. Siberian tigers they're acclimated to our summers in Buffalo, so they can live in warmer temperatures, but actually in Russia it gets very cold, up to minus 40 degrees Fahrenheit. Tigers are usually found solitary. Sometimes in the wild you'll find a female and her young together, but other than that they're usually a solitary species. Here at the Buffalo Zoo, you might see various objects in some of the animal enclosures. Sometimes you'll see big plastic barrels or traffic cones, and it's what we call enrichment, and we give it to the animals every day. It's a very important part of trying to encourage natural behaviors and playtime among our animals. All species of tigers right now are currently endangered, and most of that is through habitat loss and through hunting for poaching, and in Asia a lot of times they sell body parts of tigers for Chinese medicine.